their quarterback, and their field general.
What I enjoyed this week is that you were asked to talk to his offensive center before the game and find out a little bit more about him and what the relationship is. And that's a pretty positive story, wasn't it?
Yeah, and really what I took away from that is just how it has permeated throughout the entire offensive line, the relationship they've had. It's really a group that's in sync.
They care about him. That's the thing. They really care. And when you care that much, you're going to play that much harder for him and give a better chance to lead the team to wins. Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Defender in the secondary now for third down.
Let's go.
From the gun, Bennett. And the throw ball going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defense is charting. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And he gets this away. Look at this. This is a good one. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And on the first drive, 3 and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of the game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically, what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of the game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Great fake, yeah. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
Let's go, let's go. That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to know. They don't want those
guys. The instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though we completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them make the turn down.
Pass play round up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Level set to throw.
What the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
So they come up first and 10 now from the 43.
Cut.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, because some of these shorter gains turn into bigger ones later.
They'll run it out of the gun. And he'll take this half over to 40 without the 41. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They stacked him up pretty well, but he's trying to run the football. So they're going to get a long game. Keep handing it to him until those runs aren't working now. They turn to 6, 7, 8, and maybe more.
Finish it off here with a shorter completion, this time for the score.
I like how they start with a down there, right? The big pass play. Got the momentum going, right? That's how you create it with a play like that. And you come right back with another pass play to finalize things off.
Now the extra point try forthcoming.
Until they stop it.
Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
Let go.
First down, here's White.
Having to deal with these guys. They come in hungry, mean, and confident. They think that no one can block them.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Second and 10.
You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Oh, but you're good at it.
Well, I try. All right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly as you described. Footwork that led to the incompletion.
This will be caught in the backfield. He will not be able to get the first as he can get this only down to the five. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rally to make the tackle.
And now out is the Cardinal field goal team here. This is a fairly straightforward 22-yard short attempt. It's good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they cannot punch it in.
According to defense, too, make sure that that happens, because that's a big but don't break a punch. Made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
Just four as they kick it away and turn things over to their game. Field it about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. Swallowed up, because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Should be the final play before the quarter ends. The Score on EA Sports.
Trying to quick hit her inside, but that one was swallowed up because when they're hoping,
those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through.
Down.
Didn't happen.
70 in
here. Second and seven now from the 28.
Let's go.
Back to the ground. This time, Cook. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up third and about six.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
Yeah.
There's Bennett on third down. This is caught by Jackson. He'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 22. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you at important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Ready? This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. A Cardinal first down on a gain of 13.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
60 out there.
Exactly right. Gavin can have some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Maybe the 31, defensively rallying to the ball after the nice move. It's a six-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
Just talking about football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight.
On second down, they run the right. And it'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage is coming through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that. Because the defense might be moved on with balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
You ain't doing that today.
Sustained drive by the offense.
Now the try here for the point after. And this up. So this drive spans seven plays. And the Cardinals cap it with a touchdown. As the kick's away. This will be fielded at the six. They'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards. We got to the 27-yard line. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They didn't really want a field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they want to make sure they love him up because as he's helped him out.
Now we'll see if the offense can put six on the board. We'll see.
Should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case. That play got bottled up. Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
6 there on first. Four receivers now. Three to the right, one to the left. Second down and four. One to throw. As he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. The Cards go a nickel after defensive back out there now on third down.
Spin my up.
observation. There's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit.
But
in the second quarter, a lot of time to change things.
Let's go.
Now Bennett to throw. Throwing again. It's caught by Jackson. The Cardinals forced to bring their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. They face a third and four after that last completion gets them six. Back to throw. Bennett. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
So to see if either side can pull away, we'll get you right back out to Brandon and Charles for the start of the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Touchdown!
extra point attempt to come here. And they will take a 7-point lead now. So they hit pay dirt on just one play. The long run, the scamper, and a very nice scamper into the end zone for the touchdown.
Fire.
And here's Bennett from the downhill throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield.
4-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down.
What hallmark of good defense is? It's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. And we just saw that on this play right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. And now the Bears coming out as they get ready. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you gotta feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Crossing route. It's all
always interesting to watch that chess match.
Yeah, and I think safeties don't mind crossing routes against zone, because eventually you're going to run into their territory, and that's when they lift their chops in order to get the big hit or a play on the ball.
Offensively, nice execution to find a hole, make the catch.
Mike 17.
Yeah, let's go Savage.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
What we got?
He's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they showed passing formation, showing the shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
9th play coming up here on this drive. This is third of the
So many ways, Brandon, because number one, you get them tight.